representing Indonesia.
This crowd making huge noise inside the stalled out Istora Senayan.
Alive from Jakarta, Indonesia, get ready for a night of non-stop martial arts action.
Final instructions from our center referee, Yuji Shimada. It is the first of our prelim matches here at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. It's one championship conquest of champions. Rudy Augustian versus Astroful Islam, Indonesia versus Bangladesh in a flyweight match. The Jeet Kune Do styling of Astroful Islam. Began Jeet Kune Do in 2012, of course, the martial arts style invented by Bruce Lee, Jeet Kune Do. Rudy Augustian is a Muay Thai stylist.
Look for Islam to attack the lead leg of Rudy Augustian. He's going to try to stomp it, he's going to try to throw low kicks. He wants to limit Rudy Augustian's ability to maneuver out of the way of his powerful side kicks.
Both men just testing the water so far here in the opening round. Set for three. Outside leg kick attempt there from Islam. Rudy dances out of the way, back to center cage. There's the outside thigh kick, misses there for Islam. High kick from Rudy, trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck.
Ashraful has a very explosive style. He comes from a point competing background where he likes to jump in and jump out. So look for him to really try to move in, explode, and then get out as quickly as possible to avoid the counter shots of Augustian.
Rudy goes for the outside lead thigh of the southpaw Ashraful Islam. Islam in the red and black tries to stop for the lead knee. Still both men tipping their feet to the water, so to speak. A high kick there from Rudy.
Real heavy kicks coming from both these guys.
Outside leg kick there from Islam. Goes to the inside leg via Rudy. 3 minutes, 10 remaining. First round, Yuji Shimada wants to see some more action from these two warriors. High kick there from Rudy. Throwing that roundhouse kick off the back leg, dropped his arm, and Ashraful Islam almost came over the top of the counter. Jab there from Islam, southpaw. Nice double forearms guard against the high round kick from Rudy. Tries to return the favor off the back leg. Rudy, enough of the strike. He maybe wants to take this one to the ground, Mitch.
Yeah, that's what he said he was looking to do. He was looking to test the waters on the feet with Islam, and then eventually start to work into the clinch position. Look for him to change levels. He might try to attack the legs here. He's doing good at the stand-up. You know, he's landing that big shot. I'd like to see him maybe work the body or the legs a little bit with those kicks. Just to get Islam to drop his hands down a little bit, because right now, Islam is able to block and counter all those punches.
Point strike there to Rudy Augustian of Indonesia. We'll get some recovery time here. Have a look at the knee here from Ashraful Islam in the clinch against the cage. There it goes off the right leg. And I'd say that's pretty much on target. You've got the target you want to hit. Ashraful Islam, as I said, has a Jeet Kune Do background, being trained in that martial art for 6 years. Jeet Kune Do, a hybrid martial art developed by Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee's first ever martial art style was Wing Chun Kung Fu. Chun was actually one of the very few martial arts styles developed by a woman. I believe developed by a nun. You see a lot of trapping hands, you see a lot of those short side kicks to the knees in Wing Chun. Of course, Bruce Lee added so many more components to it. And here's our official entry time rulings. Now, Rudy will be allowed 5 minutes for medical examination and recovery if he's unable to go on. A decision may be given, but he's okay to go on here.
Okay?
Yuji Shimada just telling Islam, keep the knees either up or down. Inside leg kick there from Ashraful Islam. Good roundhouse kick from Rudy. Every time he's thrown that roundhouse in the round, it's getting progressively stronger, Mitch.
Now he's starting to change. Oh, nice little counter left hand there from Islam. But that's what he's doing. He's mixing up the target. So he's there. He went a little bit lower. He attacked the body. See if Ashraful Islam can drop that elbow down a little bit more to protect that body. So it's a wise decision on Rudy Agustin's part to start mixing up the targets there.
Outside crescent kick there from Islam. Then goes to the inside lead thigh. Good placement on that leg kick. Rudy shoots in, single leg, gets a takedown. We're on the canvas for the first time in this match.
Good job by Agustin to trap that hip. You know, he immediately went right hand over the body, pulled his Islam's hip in nice and tight, so you could see Islam's not able to start shrimping away or hip escaping away in the opposite direction. You can see that right hand right there is keeping nice and tight to his hip. He's got that elbow locked in there. Look for him to crucifix now. He's going to try to pin down the right arm of Ashraful Islam. See right there that right arm? You can see right now he's going to try to posture up. Rudy Agustin likes. You got to be careful. Can't give up the back like that. Got to be careful on that bridge.
Rudy has the back of Ashraful Islam. Does have one submission in his five wins. Rudy Agustin, Indonesian flyweight champion from Tangerang on the western outskirts of Jakarta. Rowdy young child has really turned his life around through dedication to the martial arts. Finds himself in full mount now. Tries to posture up to work some ground and pound. Islam throws the legs up, hoping to find something. And Rudy looking to measure his shots here.
He might be able to try to slide out the back door if he can get his feet up a little bit higher, but this is the bad way to try to escape. You know, all Rudy has to do is keep his weight forward, and he's going to be able to position there. He heard the clicker. He might attempt an armbar, but it looks like Ashraful Islam is going to be able to save the arm right there, and because he's saved by the bell.
End of the first round, set for three. It's our first prelim here in Manila. It's one championship, conquest of champions.
Here's some of these thunderous shots. Nice one to the body. Landed right there from Rudy Agustin. He went to the body. See, Islam's going to have to start dropping that arm. And then he went up top and was able to connect to the head right there. That was about half forearm, half toes to the head. But that's the idea. He wants to mix up those targets on the kicks. So Ashraful Islam has to protect. He has to choose which is the worst. Do I want to protect the head and risk getting hit in the body? Or do I want to keep that elbow nice and low and protect my body? I like Agustin to keep going back to that body kick, keep going to that head kick, mix up the targets well. But you can see just how dominant he was once things hit the ground.
Don't forget to go on the One Super app, and you can vote for the bout of the night. We're giving away an all-expenses-paid trip to a One Championship event. Simply go download the One Super app and vote for the bout of the night. Shaping up to be a very interesting one here in this first prelim match between Ashraful Islam in the black and red and Rudy Agustin in the black and yellow.
Ashraful Islam needs to keep this on the feet. If Rudy, you know, shoots in for that double leg or that single leg, which he did earlier or later part of round one, Islam's got to push the head down. He's got to sprawl heavy. He didn't have very good takedown defense on that takedown attempt by Agustin, so Islam's got to be careful to keep this on the feet. He might want to not let himself get backed up to the cage like this. I want to keep moving around.
There is that wicked high right round kick from Rudy that's been effective so far. And again, trying to break down the arms of Islam. Islam catching them with a double forearm scar, but those round kicks will take their toll. They cause Islam to drop his hands and allow Rudy to come clean over the top.
There's that single. He's got to sprawl. He's got to push the head down. See, he can't hold on to the head like that. You got to push the head away. Create that space so you can sprawl.
Islam trying to post up on his right arm as he hit the canvas. 3:45 remains. Let's see where Rudy can go from here. Had some dominance towards the end of the first round while on the ground. Took the back, took full mount. Looking to advance his position here, Mitch.
Yeah, you see those knees, right? Those knees were the only thing keeping Agustin away, but now he's lost those knees. So now you can see Rudy has fully passed into side control. There are no legs of Ashraful Islam to protect him from keeping the distance from those knees.
Clean knees between the eyes here of Ashraful Islam. Cuts in the hip from side control, does Rudy Agustin of Indonesia.
Let's see if Rudy tries to crucifix that arm. He might try to push the right arm of Islam down, trap that arm so he can let go a little bit of the ground and pound. Ashraful Islam needs to let go of the head. You know, he's preventing Rudy Agustin from posturing up and landing big shots, but he's not gonna do anything by holding on to the head like that. He actually puts himself in danger of being choked if Rudy Agustin can just wrap his arm around the head and drive that shoulder into his Islam's neck. He can choke him. But he doesn't seem too comfortable with that technique, so he might just try to, yep, now he's got the head out. Now he's gonna try, just continue to soften him up. Maybe look to, see he's trying to get that arm. See, he's trying to pin his arm between his legs like this. So then Islam's not able to defend.
Agustin, 5-2 record, 3 knockouts, 1 sub, 1 decision with trainer Francino Tirta in his corner. In Golden Camp, Pitbull Academy. Double-handed defense on the wrist there by Ashraful Islam off of his back. Still can't get Rudy to move from this side control position. Islam 2-1 record, 1 TKO, 1 decision with Ishtar Ahmed in his corner, the team from Extreme MMA.
You can see Rudy Agustin is trying to crucifix the arm, but he's just not getting success with it. You just might want to forget about that. Posture up and just start letting him down. Fall.
Ground and pound now from Rudy. That side control position, far arm, got it pinned down at the moment, drops an elbow off the right. Nicely done from the Indonesian. All our Indonesian fans can, of course, watch on SCTV, our main card later on, Conquest of Champions, live from Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, Philippines.
Looking for a possible Kimura, but this is that cage control that we were talking about at the beginning. When we had those three graphics up, we had striking, grappling, and cage control. See how Rudy Agustin is able to just control where this match is going and the positions that Islam is in. So now Islam's able to scramble back up to his feet. Now he needs to push away, get back to what he's good at, and that's that striking.
Islam trying for the tie, clinch of the high knees to no real avail though. 45 seconds remains, second round of 3 of this flyweight contest. Outside leg kick there from the Bangladeshian Ashraful Islam.
Like, see Islam just stick with the hands. Maybe try to time the entry because Rudy's gonna shoot in again. Maybe not at this round, but he's gonna do it in the third round. Maybe just go with the punches and look to time that entry into the single leg with an uppercut or a knee, because he hasn't really earned the respect of Rudy Agustin. Rudy's not scared to approach. Look at his hands are dropping. His movement's still nice and fluid.
Final seconds here. Islam controlling center cage, but not really getting his strikes off. The distancing isn't there. You can see that Rudy easily anticipated that lead hand coming through the center corridor. So to the outside thigh kick. And we go to the towels at the end of 2. Don't forget, download the One Super app now. Get it on Google Play. Get it at the App Store. It's all fights. It's all live. It's all free.
See, this is that one-way traffic on the ground. Rudy Agustin, see how he's able to trap the arm right there? The head is wide open and just delivering a little bit of ground and pound there with the knees to Ashraful Islam.
Folks, on the One Super app, you could win an all-expensive-paid trip to a One event. Just download the One app now and vote for the bout of the night. And what a night we have for you, including a double main event here in our main card. Edward Filiang, Amir Khan for the lightweight world title. Brandon Vera returns, takes on Italy Hammer Maro Cirilli for the heavyweight world title. Plenty of Super Series striking action and a whole lot more. Third and final round of this first prelim on tonight's card. We have 6 preliminary matches for you as the mighty Mall of Asia Arena begins to fill. We are expecting a sellout tonight. We are expecting thousands to be turned away at the door. This is the hottest ticket in Manila. Place where everyone wants to be tonight. Third and final round for Rudy and Ashraful Islam.
Islam's got to change the pace in the next 5 minutes here. He's got to do something different. He's got to score some big points on the feet, because on the ground, Ashraful Islam is getting owned.
Islam needs to bridge the gap with the striking. These jabs and the leg kicks are falling short for the Bangladeshi.
See, Michael, but now he's also a little bit timid because every time he really commits to his strikes, Agustin, you know, threatens the takedown. It gets, you know, in the back of your head that if this goes to the match, if this goes to the floor, you're going to get dominated.
Ashraful Islam in the black and red really needs to start committing on these punches. It's the lead hand, it's the outside leg kick. And not hold back now. Plenty of ground to cover with 4 minutes remaining. And referee Yuji dips into the pocket, cautions both men. He wants to see more action here. More engagement, says Yuji. Fair call there, Mitch.
I mean, it's the third round. You know, they've had two pretty tough rounds, and you know, now Agustin's got him up against the cage. You know, Yuji Shimada is a veteran referee. He knows exactly what they should be doing in there. They seem a bit tentative, at least in that first minute. So, you know, it initiated this clinch here, so I think it was the right call.
Both men having a little tango against the cage here, turning each other around. Overhook on the right arm there from Ashraful Islam. Rudy just being, should say Islam being cautioned not to thread his fingers through the cage here by referee Yuji Shimada. You can hear Yuji encouraging them, saying knee and punch. The openings are there, but no one finding them at the moment. And Yuji will separate both warriors. 3 minutes remaining now in this first prelim contest. Bangladesh versus Indonesia. That outside fly kick of Islam. He's got the right idea, says Ashraful Islam. Just hasn't connected cleanly.
I'd like to see him, instead of going for the outside, maybe go to the inside. Have a nice little double, single transfer to a double. Now he's got both the legs trapped. Agustin has shown dominance on the ground, but I think at this point he might need a finish. He's got to, you know, push things a little bit more. He's shown his dominance on the ground already, being able to control the position. But at this point, he needs to look for the finish. He needs to look for a submission.
You wonder if it's the experience factor winning out here for Rudy, or maybe it's the ring rust. Let's not forget that Ashraful Islam has not competed in the cage since December 2017. An 11-month layoff for the man from Bangladesh may it be showing here, as once again we see Rudy cut the hip inside control.
And you can see Ashraful Islam has the head control on that side, so all Agustin has to do is wrap his arm around and drive that shoulder right into the neck, and he's got a submission right there. There's a nice little von Flue choke, as it's known as, that you can just cut off the airway, drive your shoulder in, get a good squeeze, there's the choke. But the minute Ashraful Islam lets go of the head, that choke is gone. Again, you can see Agustin, he's trying to pin down the arm, but Islam is doing a good job of keeping his arms nice and tight to his body. You want to have those Tyrannosaurus Rex arms when you got somebody on top of you, because you don't want them to be able to control your arm, pin your arm down, and beat on you from that position.
1 minute 15 down. In control is the man who has owned 3 Muay Thai gyms and 2 barber shops. The Golden Boy, Rudy Agustin of Indonesia. Still inside control here. Rudy tries to pepper with that left hand to the temple of Ashraful Islam. Options are quickly running out here for the man on his back, the man from Bangladesh. Good right hand to the side of the jaw there from Rudy. Goes to side control once more. Up kick from Ashraful Islam, hoping to find something. Rudy back on the canvas, back to side mount. 30 seconds remains now. It's one-way traffic for Rudy Agustin of Indonesia. Spectacular night in Indonesia last weekend in Jakarta. It was a clean sweep for Team Indonesia. Tonight, I believe, the only Indonesian on the card is Rudy Agustin. So the sweep may continue for the Indonesians here at ONE Championship. Following on from Jakarta, they were, if I remember, 4-0 last week. Big one being Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol over Angeli Summoner. And there it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner.
about it. Rudy Augustin claims his sixth career victory tonight in Manila.